Hi everyone, Dr. Samina here, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about botanical herbs that can help to reduce testosterone that we've seen in the research. So the first herb I really want to talk about is licorice. Licorice was actually found in a 2004 study to significantly reduce testosterone levels in healthy women after 1 month of treatment. The study actually showed that licorice may exert anti-androgenic, which basically means testosterone, actions through blocking a specific enzyme called 17-hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase, which basically converts androstenedione to testosterone. It also helped to exert anti-androgenic benefits to another enzyme that converts 17-hydroxyprogesterone to androstenedione. So basically what it's doing is it's helping to block some of these enzymes that convert the precursors that we know that end up becoming testosterone. So ultimately it helps to reduce testosterone levels. There's a specific component in licorice called glycyrrhizin, and this actually helps to be that anti-androgenic property of licorice, which is really interesting. It has been shown to reduce androgenic or high testosterone-like symptoms in women with PCOS. So when we're talking about high testosterone-like symptoms, we're talking about hair loss, excessive hair growth, hirsutism, and acne. So that's licorice, that's number one. Number two is reishi mushroom. There was actually a study with reishi mushroom that actually found that it reduced levels of 5-alpha reductase. This is an enzyme that converts testosterone to our most potent testosterone called DHT, or dihydrotestosterone. And we know that higher levels of DHT can get into, you know, the skin or the sebum in the hair and cause inflammation and cause things like acne, hair loss, and excessive hair growth. So really important is reishi mushroom. The third one is white peony. And actually we know that putting it into a tincture form, so this is a liquid form of the herb, with licorice, so white peony with licorice at a 1-to-1 ratio, has been shown to help reduce testosterone as well. In this specific study, it was an older study, it was in 1991, a Chinese medicine journal actually described the component of white peony, this compound that actually inhibited the production of testosterone and promoted aromatase activity. This compound is pionafluorine, and aromatase is actually an enzyme that converts testosterone to estrogen. So it actually helps us to reduce the production of testosterone and increase the production of estrogen, which we commonly see is the biggest issue when it comes to PCOS, where we have too much testosterone and not enough production of estrogen. In the hormone pathway, what's so interesting is testosterone actually gets converted into estrogen, so that's the downstream effect of where testosterone will end up, or it'll get converted into DHT, that dihydrotestosterone. So what's happening in PCOS is that conversion is being blocked, so we're not getting enough estrogen, and mostly because it's probably getting created into more DHT, dihydrotestosterone. The third botanical or compound is actually green tea. So green tea has also been shown to have important anti-androgenic effects because it contains something called EGCG, which actually inhibits the same enzyme as we just spoke about, 5-alpha reductase, that reishi mushroom actually inhibited. So it's really important to kind of look and see what herbs are actually, what their action is to actually help reduce that dihydrotestosterone. So converting testosterone to DHT. We use 5-alpha reductase. So we're finding herbs in the research that actually help to inhibit this enzyme specifically. All right. And last but not least is saw palmetto. So saw palmetto is a very popular, I would say, herb in PCOS. Lots of talk about it. And basically, it does the exact same thing. It's a 5-alpha reductase inhibitor. And so it's going to help decrease that production of DHT. The one thing I want to make sure that you keep in mind is oftentimes on lab work, we may not see higher levels of testosterone, but if you have clinical signs and symptoms of high testosterone, such as acne or cystic acne, hirsutism, so excessive hair growth, especially on the face, the chin, the jawline, the chest, the abdomen, arms, legs, that's a sign of hirsutism, and then also hair loss. And typically hair loss can be like overall thinning. It can kind of be in this frontal area as well. And so it's really important to get assessed for clinical signs and symptoms of high testosterone, but then also testing testosterone in your blood. So we went over a few herbs today based on the research in terms of their ability to reduce testosterone. And I'm just going to review them for you. So licorice, white peony, reishi mushroom, green tea, and saw palmetto. If you have any questions at all, please drop them in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next one.